Hello my dear friends. I'm glad to see you on my channel. And I have an interesting video for the newer. Let me tell you today about what Shehzade Mustafa really was. Shehzade Mustafa in a magnificent century was presented to us as the first heir of Suleiman the Magnificent from Mahidevran. The image of the Ottoman crown prince fell in love with many viewers. Noble, just and merciful. But what was Mustafa's historical Shehzade? If you turn to the notes of his contemporaries, you can find out how much he differed from the Mustafa we were shown in the series. Ambassador Lafort arrived in Istanbul from Italy just at the moment when Suleiman inherited the throne. In his diary, he made notes that the harem of the young ruler arrived after him from Manisa. Among all the women, only one stood out. It was Mahidevran Sultan, the youngest wife of Suleiman. Together with her, her son Mustafa, whom the padishah loved very much, came to Istanbul. From a very young age, Shehzade showed great interest in history and a craving for military affairs. In his free time, he did not miss the opportunity to practice with swords or arrange fights on mattresses. According to the same Italian ambassador Lafort, Mustafa outwardly looked more like his mother. He was slender and tall, like Mahidevran. From his father, he inherited thin and crooked legs. 3 years after Shehzade Mustafa went to Manisa, Lafort left the Ottoman Empire. And 5 years later, the Venetian ambassador saw the adult heir to Suleiman. That man was Brigini. He also noted that Mustafa has a minimal resemblance to his father. Brigini also spoke very interestingly about the character of the eldest son of the Sultan. He called him rather arrogant. According to him, Mustafa looked down on all his servants and even on viziers and pashas. He acted as if his subjects were not worthy of even one look from him. During a meeting at the council, the crown prince could taunt the vizier in his place. It even happened that Shehzade went against his father. But with the Janissaries, Mustafa was completely different. He considered them almost the main asset of the Ottoman Empire. Suleiman did not like this behavior of his son at all. But Shehzade Mustafa was not worried at all. He didn't seem to need his father's support. Being confident in his superiority, Shehzade often did everything in his own way, and did not obey his father, the padishah. Contrary to tradition, Mustafa wore a beard when, according to the rules, only the sultan had the right to wear a beard. Mustafa also concluded nikah with three of his concubines, which was also strictly prohibited. In addition, these marriages were completely meaningless from the point of view of politics, since they did not carry any benefit for the state and the dynasty. In the records of Brigini, information was found that Suleiman's attitude towards his eldest heir was getting worse and worse every day. Apparently, this was due to the fact that the padishah began to see Mustafa not as his son, but as an enemy and rival. It is possible that this was influenced by his legal wife harem. The sultana could chastise her stepson in front of everyone, without fear of being punished for it. Through the efforts of harem, Shehzade Mustafa was sent from Manisa to Amasya. Leaving, Mustafa gave the Janissaries a word that he would soon return back, and after his return, the life of all the soldiers would become much better. Suleiman was so disappointed in his eldest son that he did not see him off. When he looked at Mustafa, Brigini noticed anger and hatred in the eyes of padishah. The word in front of him was not a son, but a sworn enemy. Mustafa's self-confidence, violation of traditions, the similarity of Shehzade with her mother, marriages with concubines, a grown beard, disrespect for her own father, as well as the influence of harem on Suleiman, according to the Venetian, all this together pushed the Sultan to execute his eldest heir. Other contemporaries of Suleiman the Magnificent noticed that, in proportion to the growing up of Shehzade Mustafa, the abyss between him and his padishah father grew. This became noticeable already at the time when they lived under the arch of the Topkapi Palace. And this was explained by the fact that Mustafa was very similar to his mother, not only in appearance, but also in his character. This is what Suleiman did not like so much. Be that as it may, the real Shehzade Mustafa was the exact opposite of Mustafa from our favorite series Magnificent Century. Friends, what do you think? What was Shehzade Mustafa really like? Like in the series, or like it was described by the ambassadors of that time. Write your opinion in the comments. I'll be glad to know what you think about it. I thank you for watching. give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And continue to stay with me so as not to miss new interesting stories about the Ottoman Empire. See you soon.